It is my pleasure to meet you all and to introduce this research here. The research is about solar powered water treatment plant with zero liquid discharge. As the name says, it's a complete study on the desalination treatment plant powered by green energy and with no impact in the environment with steady technology. Due to the short time, I will focus on the deadlines and the results. So any question will be for motivated. The outlines include introduction, literature review, practical work, rare plant design, economic study, and conclusions. Nowadays, water, energy, food are the main concern on the world. So where the sheriff Nile and the Fernando Schwest can Sheriff Nile is the main source of in Egypt and the agriculture. The field is representative core two in the freshwater in Egypt. So the aim of this research is deploying a water treatment facility that's capable of producing fresh water for irrigation from underground water, design a solar system to supply the power required for this facility, construct a zero discharge system to reduce the negative impact, and construct and operate a bioplanet that simulates the climate effect. The literature review first the definition technology includes two processes, thermal and membrane. The thermal includes multi-phase plus distillation, multi-phase distillation, vapor compression, and in the membrane process, such as electrolysis, membrane distillation, osmosis, and osmosis. The membrane process is preferred over the thermal process due to the higher breathing cost and fixed cost. The RO have lower corrosion, and the overall is suitable for this research cylinder. The first notes have covered from 50 to 80% impact water and from 20 to 40% in seawater with both salt reduction from 90 to 98%. However, the RO need a bar that can be provided by solar system. The solar system, concrete system includes solar panels that convert sunlight to electric and charge controls that relate charge to batteries. The inverter that converts the DC current to the AC. And zero liquid charge is an advanced water process that used for the environmental regulations, scarcity of water, and to increase the profit by recycling waste water, reducing soil pollution, and no waste water use. The zero liquid charge is usually an irrigation system, but due to the high salinity of water, a fish farm will be applied, and by time the salinity increase, so a pollution bond will be used after the fish farm. The practical work includes design of bioplanet, the optimum parameters affecting the population in bioplanet, characterization of reduced water. First, the bioplanet is used to simulate the real planet. As it's shown, the solar panels generate the electricity to the battery. Inverter converts the DC to AC and here the feed is pumped from the feed tank to the filtration completion tank, where the alarm is introduced to remove the suspended solid, and the sealing is done to mix the water with alarm and then let to settle. After that, the RO tank will be partially loaded with water and then send the water to a multimedia filter of polyurethane and carbon block. Polyurethane to make sure that there is no solvent solid in the water, and carbon block to remove the chlorine that may harm the RO if exists. Then the RO separates the high test water to the concentration and the low test water to minerals and UV used in the drink. The lab results for the optimum parameters affecting the coagulation process is found to be the dose is 250 ppm and set of time 20 minutes, mixing rate 1000 rpm with efficiency removing 75%. The coagulation and filtration tank was designed to achieve the highest capacity for our pilot to make up for the long time of session while maintaining the pilot size as small as possible. The Arduino is used to control and operate the pilot line. And according to this analysis, the red blank will be used to create underground water to be used for irrigation. Then there's a real planet. First, the feed water is sent to a sand filter from the feedstock tank to remove the solvent solid, after which other filtration will be used to remove the viruses, microbes, and the large solid particles that may harm the RO. The RO have two products. First, the permeate that is used in irrigation, then the concentrate that will be sent to a steering tank to add chemicals to react with calcium and magnesium that exist in high concentration in the concentrate stream and may harm the RO. The clarifier is used to remove the reaction products and also sand filter and other filtration is used for the RO number two. The RO, the second RO have two products also, permeate. That has slightly higher TDS than the permeate number one. And so the it's sent to a floating head tank that have three outlet streams. The first stream is used in a mixture to recycle with the feed water. And the other two stream is used as a backwash to ultrafiltration. And the concentrate is sent to a floating head tank with three outlet streams. The first to the ZL unit and the other two as a backwash to a sand filter. After which the backwash streams will be sent to a ZL unit. First, the first smooth design. In order to design the first RO, we provide the program IMCD, Integrated Membrane Solution Design, with this specification. And it was found that 60 membrane element of SBA2 LED max is required to obtain the maximum recovery of 79%. However, the concentrate stream from the first RO that will be sent to the second RO need to be treated because of the increase in calcium and magnesium that can cause scaling to the second RO. So the removal of calcium and magnesium will be in the sixth or the tank. As the following table shows the dimensions and the steering bar is shown in this table with power required 18 kilowatts. The chemicals needed are NaOH and sodium carbonate that produce more NA in the new stream. And the following table shows the needed chemicals and the produced NA. So the second RO is found that it needs 42 membrane elements of SCWC5 LED to obtain the maximum power of 61%. The permeate from the second RO, which will be recycled in the mixer with the raw water, and the mass balance is applied to get the new feed stream. The recycle is done to decrease the underground water needed, decrease the permeate TDS, and increase the overall recovery. The zero liquid discharge design includes three parts. First, the fish bond that can handle 46,000 PM, and then Artemia bond that can handle higher TDS range, and eventually the vibration bond. as the design is based on the evaporation rate in Egypt, where the area needed for the whole system is 4.77 acres. The solar system is designed to provide the power required in RO pump and in the steering part in mixer and C store and the underground pump and the feedstock pump. As a 100 kilowatt solar system is designed with this specification. Then the economic study. The profit is not gained by selling the water, but from the from using it in agriculture and from the ZDL green. The economic cost almost cost 3 million Egyptian pounds. The total capital investment of this equipment is 11 million. The total capital investment of the whole project, including the equipment, solar panel, the irrigation, the ZDL is 17 million. The production for 1 cubic meter of produced water is 12 Egyptian pounds. The return of investment is almost 62%. The conclusions, the best in the distillation technology process research is found to be RO. The optimum RO membrane is found to be SBA2 LED max for the first RO and SWC5 LED for the second RO. The designed rear connect is capable of producing 57 cubic meter per hour. The chemical needed for in the softening process are sodium hydroxide and sodium carbonate. The required total area for the LED is 4.77 acres. The solar system designed to provide 100 kilowatt per hour. 17 million is the total capital investment of the project, including the planning, equipment, PV panels, agriculture, and the LED. The return of investment is almost 62%. And thank you.
Thank you, Ahmed.
Save the water from Nile that used in agriculture for the low salinity crops like lemons, orange.
Excellent. I'm just asking about the productivity. How much? How
for 1 cubic meter in agriculture, we the profit is 61 Egyptian pounds for 1 cubic meter, and for the ZDLG is 2.5 Egyptian pounds for 1 cubic meter. The underground water was 2,000 and above. Yeah, you can use it for irrigation for different different type of crop. The work time for our planet is in the daylight, but it works out. So we don't need for batteries.
ممكن البطاريات
Well, thank you very much.